It's been a long time since the best years of our lives, the beloved 1946 film about soldiers returning home to their families after World War II, but the story, in many ways, remains the same. In William Wyler's movie, the sacrifices of war were embodied by vet-turned-actor Harold Russell, who lost both his hands in the army. But combat injuries aren't always so visible, as evident in Thank You for Your Service, the directorial debut of American sniper writer Jason Hall, who adapted David Finkel's book for the screen. Thank You for Your Service explores the devastation of PTSD suffered by American soldiers returning home in 2007 from Operation Iraqi Freedom. Washington Post journalist Finkel embedded with a group of soldiers in Iraq to write the book The Good Soldiers, and his follow-up, Thank You for Your Service, details their readjustment to their families in civilian life while battling physical, mental, and emotional injuries. Miles Teller stars as Sergeant Adam Schumann, who struggles to find his footing back home with his wife, Haley Bennett, and kids. He seems most at ease when looking out for his boys, like he did back in Iraq, and is plagued by guilt over incidents at home and abroad when he was unable to save his buddies from injury or death. The detailing of their physical and emotional injuries is presented almost as edutainment, with statistics about suicide and careful questionnaires about mental distress. But it's at once an account of PTSD and a wartime mystery. While these young vets struggle to receive treatment for their combat stress, traumatic brain injuries, and suicidal thoughts, they also speak cryptically about what happened to Doster, one of their comrades who died, leaving behind a distraught widow, Amy Schumer, searching for answers. While parts of Thank You for Your Service work well, overall the film is inconsistent. A middle section lays out a perfect villain that is disappointingly dropped, the governmental system that churns through boys and leaves them alone to navigate the bureaucratic nightmare that is veterans' affairs, while admonishing them that it's bad for morale to ask for help. This biting social commentary is abandoned for a misguided subplot involving Solo, Beulah Cole, Adam's buddy, getting caught up in a bad situation with a drug dealer, a Desert Storm vet. It's extremely disappointing that the film ultimately positions the real threat as a fellow vet, a man of color, rather than the war machine that chewed them up and spit them out.